Hey everybody, I'm just going to do another quick podcast. Actually, it's not a podcast, it's a statement or a comment. I'm going to make a statement and a comment. I like to say, like a politician, do you want to make a comment or a statement? Or a yes or a no, or maybe, or a yes or a no. Well, this time on my podcast, I'm going to do a statement or a comment in between. But I want to make a statement about a person in my life who passed away. That's two people in my life that passed away. And this is in regard to my two favorite people that I appreciate in my life, in my world. Let's put it that way. Two people I appreciate in my world. And this has to do with passing or death. And the cause, they usually say cause of death. Well, the cause of death in both people, both individuals, as they would say, one passed away to natural causes, one passed away due to cancer. If you're wondering a case of death, or as they say in the, sometimes on YouTube they'll say cause of death. Well, the cause of death is going to be cancer, and the other one passed away due to many causes, many reasons. But my dad, who was been with me ever since I was born, passed away this past February 10th, 2021. He lived to, he was 80 years old, 80. So 80 years old. Can you imagine someone living 80 years old? So this is why I'm doing this podcast for my dad, my true dad. Dad, and they would call him dad, how do you say, dad's dad, yes. Real dad, not a fake dad, as everybody wants to say. He's a man's man or a dad's dad, who helps out his best son or daughter, to get a career in whatever career they want to get into, what lifestyle they want to get into. Dads are heroes. Dads out there in the world are heroes to their daughters and sons. And that could mean any dad that's out there, any age of dads, okay? Any age of dads. It could be old dads to new dads. The ones that are younger, the better, as I would say. Younger, the better. Not when they're older, when they're 80 years old. Not when they're 90 years old to 100. When they're 80 or 90 years old, they don't want to do too much in their ripe old age of 100. That's terrible. But my dad did pass away of 80. That's 80. So he was born in the 1940s, and died just recently. And I want to say rest in peace to my dear old dad. My real dad, he's a dad's dad, and he helped me where I am today, ever since the 1970s, since I was born. So I was a 70s baby, just so you know, everybody knows that, okay? I'm a 70s baby, 1970s baby. A lot of you youngsters out there, probably born in the 90s or the 2000s. I was born in the 1970s, if you can believe it. So I came a long way from everything there is in this world today. When people look at me, they don't think I'm middle-aged, but I am middle-aged. Once they look at me, they think I'm a lot older than I look. So middle-age would be around between 40 and 50 in terms of age. So yeah, I'm middle-aged. And I came a long way. I've seen a lot of things in my lifestyle that you ever dreamed of in the 40 plus years. So this is honest truth. My dad, who passed away recently, he was a dad's dad, a real dad, you know, like a real dad. He's not like a second dad that I have to have. But yeah, he's my real dad, a dad of all dads. Man's man, should we say, man's of all man's. And this is what, I'm just going to say, the next year I'm going to celebrate 1 year anniversary of my dad's passing, next year. So, and every February 10th is going to be his anniversary when he passed away. That'll be the day that we celebrate the passing of my dad. He was 80 years old when he passed away. Can you believe it? He made it till he was 80. So that's a long time. That's a long time. I was born in the 70s. I'm not going to give you the year, but I was born in the 70s all the way up till now. So you can imagine. I'm middle-aged. You can call me middle-aged if you want. Yeah, a lot of people think I'm turned 30 or 20. I'm not 20 or 30. I once was. But like I said, I see everything in my lifestyle that I need to see. I travel the world as much as I can in my ripe old age, and I've seen everything you can think of. I've seen every rock star there is to A to Z. Every star you can think of, even including Justin Bieber, if you can believe it. The Justin Bieber of the world, the singer of Justin Bieber. He had an on and off relationship with Selena Gomez, if you can believe it. It was true in the public consumption. On and off relationship with Selena Gomez. Can you believe this? She's a fashion designer. No wonder Justin Bieber liked her. She had some fashion sense. I don't know if that really. And then all of a sudden Justin Bieber married this other woman. She came out of blue. Like I didn't even know this woman. You know, if I were Justin Bieber, this is my recommendation. If I were Justin Bieber, I would just dump her and go on to somebody else. I would. Yeah. But just remember. Oh, by the way, speaking of Justin Bieber, apparently he has a band. He has a real live band. And he's 23 years old. Can you believe it? He's 23 years old at the moment. I'm not older than him, in terms of age. So he's 23 years old, I'm 45. You can tell how long I've been in this industry. And I just say to Justin Bieber, I'm really appreciating what he's accomplished in this world. But I don't like his music at all. Completely don't like his music. No matter what song he's on, I don't like any of his songs. Not one of them. So, you can tell. So, my this is not a real rant. This is basically a complaint, or a comment, or a statement. So, just so you know. So, I just want, this topic only has to do with my dad, who passed away recently. And my best friend, Thunder Naps. May you rest in peace, Thunder Naps. He wants to be called Thunder Naps. He has an alias name. Just so you know, he has an alias name. Not his real name, but an alias name. A.K.A. Thunder Naps. And he wants to be called that. And he just coined that name. Thunder Naps. He thinks he's got the thunderous touch. That's what he's claiming. But in my eyes, he can be whatever he wants to be. He can have an alias name. You can have avatar. Yeah. So I just want to point this out that Thunder Naps, may you rest in peace, my brother, and my dad, who is 80 years old. May you rest in peace forever and ever into eternity. God puts us into eternity. He's going to come back on this earth again. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, is going to come back on this planet one of these days. There's no timetable. There's no month, year, time, or day. But the second coming is coming. The Bible mentions that in the resurrection. I'm not kidding. You can laugh all you want, but Jesus Christ is coming back the second time. And I want to be alive when I see this happening. He's gonna wake up the whole world. He's gonna wake up the whole world. And all this negativity that's on this world, all the badness, that the evilness, the demons on this planet, to the hauntings, to the devilish people, the evilest people, the German people, to the Germany people, to, yeah, so just all the evil stuff that happened on this planet, Jesus is going to come back and praise the people in our planet. And I believe this. I believe it's my heart of hearts, you know, the heart of hearts thing. I believe in all my heart that Jesus is going to come back. This is not a prediction. This is real true. Just so you know, Bible mentions that in the resurrection. Jesus coming back. I want to see my own eyes that Jesus coming back. In full form. This is in full form. In full form. I want to see him in a shining light. In a shining light. You hear me out there on YouTube? A shining light. I want to see you in full bloom. I want to have my camera ready when I film this thing. Yeah. And I want to give a shout out to all my YouTubers, all my cool creators out there who do YouTube for a living. It doesn't matter what lifestyle you get into. Just be careful when you're doing YouTube videos out there. I'm not going to mention names who the YouTubers are, have YouTube users' names. But I have 200 users on my YouTube platform. 200 users, 200 subscribers, just so you know. I have 200 subscribers that I subscribe to. It can range from A to Z. So I'll give you a long list of names on YouTube users out there that I come to appreciate in my life. Yeah. And these are true YouTuber people that I once knew long time ago and way back in 2012. When I started my YouTube channel, I got these YouTubers on my YouTube channel, and I appreciate it to this day. Not so much now than I did back then. But I want to give a shout out to these YouTubers that I come to appreciate. I want to give out the shout out to the Shaytards. They know who they are. I want to give a shout out to iJustine. You people know who Justine is. She has a lot of subscriber base out there. Every subscriber base that's out there. I want to give a shout out to all my co-creators out there on YouTube. Keep doing your content. We need content out there. That's what YouTubers keep saying. Content. We need content out there. We need to create those content that the viewers appreciate. That appreciate. Most importantly, I'm going to say it loud and proud. You say it loud and proud, and I will say it loud and proud. I'm the voice of the voiceless out there. Do you hear me out there? I want to make sure everybody, and I can speak, I can read people's minds. I can read what they're thinking, what they're saying, to just by the sound of their voice, I know what age they're at. So give me a person's voice and I'll tell you how old he is. So, I just want to let you know that I'm here for a reason. I put on this planet for a reason. I'm not just plopped here for doing no good. I'm here for a reason, just so everybody gets this. I'm here for a reason, and that's reason only. To get content out there for you YouTubers out there. And don't be scared, it's just me, it's little old me, it's nobody else. I'm trying to be real as much as possible. I don't put on a mask. I'm not a character on TV. I'm put in a position. So I'm not a creator. I'm so-called criticism out there. I want to put my voice to the voiceless out there. I speak for 1,000 people out there. Imagine if you're in the woods and just by yourself. I'm speaking for that person out there. You know, I come from voice to the voiceless. I give voice to everybody who wants to be voiceless, who needs a voice out there. I give credence to kudos to everybody. That's pretty good. That's pretty awesome, right? That's pretty awesome. Just say it out there. That's pretty awesome, eh? Yeah. I just want to say I'm here for a reason. I'm only here for a reason. I call it out. I really call it out on YouTubers out there. I really call them out. No question about it. When I see great content, I call it out when I see it. And those cop watchers, they are pretty good. Those guys with the First Amendment auditors, they are awesome. Remember, everybody, tell those auditors they're awesome. They go out there and do what they need to do best. Just film the police. Just remember, they always film the police. Go out there and film the police with your cameras. You're a photographer. Remember, you're a photographer. Go get a camera. Film everything that has to do with outside in your little world. And Justin Bieber gets it out there. I appreciate you, my brother. I really do. You're doing pretty good, Justin Bieber. Just keep up what you're doing. Keep up doing your music. We love you. You're a Canadian. You're a Canadian Christian. I heard that you're a Christian guy. There's a lot of people out there that look like you, Justin Bieber. There's guys out there that have the same mentality out there, just like Justin Bieber does, that want to like, have a music career and really sustain that music career the longest time. And, you know, at one time I believed in you. I believed in you so many times. I believe in you. The content you put out, the music you put out, I believe in you so heartily. And Drake, I believe in you, Drake. I want to give a shout out to the musicians out there. And I'm a singer-songwriter myself. I just want you to know that I'm a singer-songwriter, first and foremost. And Music Awards were on tonight, by the way. The Music Awards were on tonight. The Billboard's Music Awards tonight. And there was some heavy hitters on there. Drake was awarded the decade of the word of the decade. What you hear in the background is a YouTuber out there. In the background, I can't show the YouTuber out there, but you can hear in the background the audio. So I want to give a shout out to all the Crow creators out there on YouTube, have users' names out there, and I'm here just to. I'm the guy in the wilderness, just giving you a shout out to everybody. Oh, and by the way, I want to create that content that people appreciate on my YouTube channel. I'm here forever and ever. I will be here forever and ever. I have a YouTube, I'm going to brand it my YouTube channel. I got a channel name already, a brand new channel name. And I'm giving you guys some ideas out there. I just want you to know I give some ideas out there for you guys to create your own YouTube channels. I'm giving you some ideas. So I'm trying to brand your ideas out there. Get out there, do what you have to do best, and just create the amazing videos out there. I'm just a news person out there. Create the videos, create the content. And I want to give a shout out. Now, I haven't seen too many people out there who do videos for a living. I mean, always create that content. I love great content. You guys like great content. I like great content. I like watching wrestling. You guys like wrestling. A live stream is good. Do a live stream. Do as much live stream as you can do. And create that 2K views. I see a lot of YouTubers out there doing 2K views. And by the way, YouTubers don't get paid because of their content. They only get paid for their ads. Just remember that. YouTubers think that they get paid because of their content. No, they don't. They get money from their ads. Only from their ads, not their content that they put on there. The only way they can get paid is if YouTube were paying the creators that create these videos, get the money. By the way, in case you're wondering, folks, I'm on Patreon, did you know? Yeah, I'm on Patreon, folks. Go on Patreon. I'm there, folks. I'm there. I'm 100% there. And I just want to give a shout-out to... So I'm the voice of the voices. This is my comment or statement. I'm making a statement or a comment. My comment is... Be true to yourself. Be true to yourself. And just be nice to everybody. Just be nice to everybody. And just be nice. Promise me you be nice to everybody out there. And I'm watching CP24 on the background. You just hear the sound of CP24 in the background. And they're breaking news. They're breaking news station. And that's what you hear in the background. And Justin Bieber, I just want you to know I give kudos to you. I spoke to you on the gaming consoles. You're awesome. You're awesome. I just want you to know that. And I'm the 70s baby. Just so you know, I'm the 70s baby. And a lot of you guys are coming out from the ranks. Oh, by the way, don't forget the 20th anniversary of 9/11. I'll be doing a special on 9/11 coming up this September. I promise you guys. This September I'll do 20th anniversary of it. that morning, the actual day and time. 20 years. Can you believe it? It's been 20 years since 9/11. This happened on American soil, not on Canadian soil. And 20 years, I've seen it when it actually happened. And can you believe it? On that very day, I saw it on TV as it happens. It's no green screen. There was no green screens in those days. So if you guys start using green screens, I can tell if you're using green screens. So just remember, I'm here for you guys, not for myself. I'm here for you guys on YouTube. Yeah. I want to see YouTubers' lives go perfectly. I want to see the shining light. The shining light, I want to put the shining light on YouTubers, not for me. I've done many YouTube videos out there, a lot to mention out there. I want to make you guys a star. I want to make you guys a star, first and foremost. That's what I'm out to do. Make YouTubers a star. It's like checks the box. It really checks the box. So I just want to give kudos to that. I want to make YouTubers a star. I made myself a star on YouTube. Now I'm going to make you guys a star out there. It's time to make you guys shine on YouTube. And if you want to come to me and how to get a YouTube channel going, just come and ask me. Ask me many questions about how to get a YouTube channel going. And I'll give you tutorials on it. Yeah. If you want to start your own YouTube channel, I'll give you tutorials on step by step and how to go about it. Okay, just so you know, just start your own YouTube channel. You'll be off to the races. I promise you, you'll be having content galore. And Patreon, I just want you to know that, folks, you'll be on Patreon in no time. Because I'm just telling you, Patreon, it's where it's at. I want everybody to promote Patreon to this day, all right? This day for promote Patreon. I want YouTubers out there on their YouTube channels, promote Patreon. Okay, no, not this Twitter thing, not this Facebook thing. I want Patreon to be promoted. Not TikTok or any of these websites. Promise me that, guys. I'm going to put this on my YouTube channel, and I want you guys to promote Patreon, okay? Promise me that, guys. So, and I'm so happy. I have 200 subscribers, I'm not kidding. I have 200 subscribers that I subscribe to, and they subscribe to my channel as well. So, it works both ways. It works both ways. Just remember that, folks. It works both ways. I put out the content that you guys want to see and subscribe to my YouTube channel. My lot of viewership gets a view from the United States, not from Canada, from the United States. All my views get viewed from the United States. So, mostly, nice. I get almost around 8,000 views. I get 8,000 views, if you can believe it. Yeah, 8,000 views. So, and I want you guys to be YouTube stars out there. Really, really make that a goal for yourself. Be YouTube stars. All right, make a goal for yourself all this year. And do a review, like year in review of YouTube stars. That you could be YouTuber stars out there. The next YouTube star could be out there. You just don't know it. Yeah, who wants to be a YouTube star and become famous? I can see a diamond in the rough. Yeah. It's like Justin Bieber. Now, Justin Bieber has his own YouTube channel. I want to make the next YouTuber start to be famous out there. I want to create that content for him. It's like the McJuggernugger would say. He's got his own YouTube channel. He's got his Jesse Witchway. His real name is Jesse Witchway. And you might have heard about him on his YouTube channel. And his current girlfriend is, current girlfriend is Ashley. I'm not kidding, folks. His current girlfriend. He was about to marry her. Can you believe this? He was about to marry her. And no word of a lie. He was very close. Can you believe this? He was going to marry Ashley. But it turned out terribly. I kid you not. It turned out terribly. But I always say to people, hey, at least you tried. Okay? At least you tried. You know, it's not always on the first round. Okay? Not on the first round. So, don't worry. As I said, the other day, you know, people tried and tried. You know, keep trying. Yeah, I always say to guys and girls, if you're posing, if girls were to pose to their men and men pose to their girl and their women, it would be a lot easier. And I believe in that theory. I really do. I believe in that theory wholeheartedly. And it's always, if they're at the point of yes, they're waiting for the answer yes on that one. And when they pose to each other or they do a proposal, yes, the proposal. Sometimes, never the yes answer or never the no answers. And this guy wanted to pose to his girlfriend. I kid you not. You know, the Juggernaut, I got to hand it to him. He's pretty good. He's very epic-y. And I put that in quotations. He's very epic-y. He's all in the moment. And he went to see Stuart. He saw another YouTuber. His name is Stuart. And you might have seen him on his YouTube. You might have seen him with the Juggernaut guy. Stuart is another YouTuber who's out there, and he met him, and he's trying to. Sometimes guys get a little. It's kind of like stage fright, you know, how you pose to your girlfriend. It's like stage fright. How do you pose to your girlfriend? You can practice at home. Just practice at home. I tell you guys out there, practice at home. If you're scared to pose in front of your girlfriend, practice at home. The best recommendation I can give you is practice at home. What's that? With your own time. If you want to pose to your girlfriend, practice at home. Practice how you want to say it, so you get an idea of how to say it. That's my recommendation. If you want to pose to your girlfriend, remember, this is your lifetime girlfriend who's going to be your wife. So just remember that, folks. That's my recommendation. Juggernaut, don't worry if you failed them the first time. Don't worry about it, okay? Don't cry about it. Don't be frustrated over it. At least you tried. As I would say to guys out there, just you tried. It doesn't mean that you failed. You tried. It doesn't mean you failed on the first go-around, okay? He tried. I'll give him that. He tried. Okay, so sometimes you don't always have to get married to a girlfriend you appreciate, okay? I give people options. Like I said before, you give people options. You don't have to marry them. You can just be friends until you find the right moment. Until you find the right moment to pose to her. I would say for this for any guy out there. If you're going to pose to your girlfriend, make sure it's the right moment, right day and time to do it with. And, yeah. So that's my recommendation. I got 27 minutes here, guys. I just want to say to you guys, I hope you learned something here on my YouTube channel. And this is my statement, my comment that I made. This is about the yes and no's. And, if it's confirmed, I'll be here. If it's confirmed. And that's what I want to say to you guys. It's like saying, if it's confirmed, I'll be there anytime, anywhere. Yeah. So I want to give a shout out to all my YouTubers. I'm not going to mention the names of the YouTubers out there. I'm just going to be, it's like A to Z. It's like an alphabetical order. Yeah. And these are good YouTubers. These are not terrible YouTubers. These are really good. And they don't have an ounce of negativity over them. And they're not demon-like people. So they're not like Hitler kind of people. They're not from Germany, you know, just so you know. So the bulk of them are from the United States, the rest of them are in Canada. I just want to give a shout out to all you guys. Keep giving the content that you guys appreciate, of your own self. Don't please everybody else out there. It's hard to please everybody out there. Just please your own self. I'll put in the great content that you appreciate. Yeah, that you appreciate. You say to your, just imagine saying to your friend, saying, hey, this is a great content I put out, and it gives a thumbs up. Yeah, and remember, I just want to say to everybody, learn off me. Remember that, learn off me. You'll get somewhere in life. So, just remember, you might learn something here. Just remember that, folks. I learned 30-plus years. I learned from I learned everything I need to know as a human being on this planet. I'm still living, not died off. So, I'm going to live till I'm 80 years old. I'm going to live till I'm 80 years old. You got that out there on YouTube? 80 years old, 80. So, that's in a couple decades. And is time travel possible? Yes, it is. Time travel is definitely possible. Teleportation is possible, by the way. Go look at a YouTuber. His YouTube channel is called Apex TV. There's a channel on YouTube called Apex TV. And they talk about time travel, time travelers, and teleportation. You ever heard of the word called teleportation? Yeah, and time travel, there's a time machines out there. Teleportation means they went to the future and not the past. And these are time travelers from the future and came back and tell about it. Yeah. So what you hear in the background is a YouTuber speaking in the background and CP24 as a breaking news TV station. And in the background, I'm not going to show it to you. I'm only you'll hear it in the audio portion. What else I got to say to you guys? That don't forget, this year is the best year ever. 20 years of 9/11. The anniversary will celebrate in a special edition podcast. And one other thing before I go, before I give you the best ideas I can give you. Oh, by the way, raccoons are coming out, by the way, this year. Raccoons are coming out this year, just so you know. Raccoons are coming out. This is the big raccoons are coming out. And, yeah, be very careful of the raccoons, everybody. So, raccoons are very big and very small. They come in sizes and shapes. So, by the way, I'm a big believer of paranormal stuff. I'm a big believer of I almost made a mistake there. Anyway, I just want to say to you guys, the paranormal stuff and the poltergeist stuff. I do like Ghost Adventures with Zach. I like that guy Zach on the Ghost Adventures. And I like Ghost Hunters. Remember that TV show Ghost Hunters? They had a team with their own paranormal guys, and they go hunt. They go haunted locations. These are abandoned buildings. These are abandoned buildings. I kid you not, abandoned buildings. So, yeah, they go abandoned buildings, and the 1800s. These are from the 1800s. These are not like new buildings. Yeah. And they're haunted. Sometimes they'll have stories. Can you believe this? They'll have stories. I'm going to sound in stereo, not monolith sounding. Yeah. So the award show was on tonight, 8 to 11 o'clock. And I'm so happy. I'm very much happy. I'm almost tired here, guys. I'm almost tired. I'm sorry. I'm drowning your energy. I'm sorry, guys. So I just want to appreciate everything that you guys do out there, no matter what lifestyle you get into, you know, we have one world. We have one world and one God. Remember that. One world and one God. And the Bible, if you think the resurrection, you say, as my friend would say, the resurrection is coming. Jesus Christ is coming, guys. No word of a lie. I believe in this theory. If you guys think of conspiracy theories, I'm going to work on this. God is coming back. It's no evangelism or you know, this is not churchgoers. This is not preached to the preachers. I believe in this theory that Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior, is coming back. This is my own theory. Yeah. And you can have theories of your own. You can have all the theories you want in life, but I want to make it my own. And don't forget Coast to Coast AM with George Nori. That's right. Go to his website. It's coasttocoastam.com. Don't forget that. Don't forget George Nori and George Knapp. Yeah. And Art Bell. Don't forget Art Bell. Oh, don't forget Art Bell. He's long gone, but don't forget Art Bell. Yeah. We'll be right back after this commercial break. Don't touch that dial. We'll be right back. Yeah. And one other thing, this is a crazy world we're living in. I kid you not, we're living in a crazy world today. We got the pandemic going on, we got mask wearing. This is craziness. Make sure if you've been with a girlfriend for a long period of time, just promise me you'll marry her. Promise me you'll marry her. So there you go. I want everybody to marry the best girlfriend out there. The best girlfriend. All right? I want to make sure they marry the best girlfriend out there. You know, their soulmate. I call it the soulmate. And so make sure you have a right girlfriend. They just soulmate. You want to have the best girlfriend ever, right? Am I right? The best girlfriend out there. Yeah, you have the heart of a lion, and you're the best guy around there. You should marry her. You should definitely marry her. Yeah. And I want to give kudos to that juggernaut guy, Jesse Ridgway. I guess that's what his name is. And that's his real name, by the way. And he's 28 years old. He's 28 years old, my friend. And he knows a lot of YouTubers out there. A lot of YouTubers that he knows on YouTube. And it's good to know. It's good. I want to point this out. Hold on for a sec. I want to point this out for a sec. That God is real. God is definitely real. And our souls are real. When we pass away, our soul goes out of our body and goes in the atmosphere. Just remember, when we pass away in the afterlife, our soul never dies. Remember that. Say that 20 times. Our soul never dies. Yeah. Our body is long gone underground, but our soul will live on in the afterlife. Just so you know, we'll have special devices to communicate to you as an individual in the afterlife. Yeah, and I believe in this theory. Can you give me a hell yeah? Thank you. Hell yeah. Yeah. Anyway, just say to yourself, your soul will never die. Your soul will never die. Keep saying that to yourself, everybody. Your body will, but your soul will never die. I got this from Hawk Paranormal. And he gave me a lot of knowledge. He gave me a lot of knowledge, by the way, just so you know. A lot of knowledge. So anyway, I'm gonna leave it at that. Good night, everybody. Good night. And this is my recommendation, my comment and statement. I just want to point that out. And what you hear in the background is a TV station and a YouTuber's name. I'm not gonna give out the YouTuber's name. Not to give him kudos to. You'll hear his voice. I'll give you a sample of what he sounds like in the background. Yeah. This is what he sounds like. Let's hear him. Yeah. So this is what he sounds like in the background. Just listen. Yeah. That's what he sounds like in the background, everybody. You hear what he says? So anyway, I'm just recording this for prosperity. I hope you know that. I'm recording this for prosperity. And I want to keep it forever and ever. I want to keep it forever and ever. You got that? Ever and ever. To eternity. And, God is in eternity, we're in eternity. There's no time in the world. Time has no meaning. Remember that, time has no meaning. Even the Bible mentions that. So, it's not like looking at your watch and saying, what time is it? No, it's in God's time. Remember, it's in God's time. You gotta believe it, what the world thinks of you. God believes in you. God thinks of you, God knows who you are as an individual person. Yeah. Believe in what you believe in, and he'll do the rest. Just remember that. God will, don't be a follower, you be the follower. Don't follow other people, but you be a follower. Alright, just remember that. Put that to rest. Say you be the follower, don't let other people be the follower. Okay? And I will be back much later, everybody, much later. And this is, I'm stating the facts, if it's confirmed, I'll be here every single day if it's confirmed. Yeah, if it's a yes or no, maybe, or a comment or a statement. I'm making a statement and a comment. And we're going to get to yes, and we're going to get to no, and we're going to get to maybe. Maybe word. Yeah. And I want to give kudos. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening to me. I want to appreciate all the love that I give to you guys out there. I'll have this on YouTube in an hour or so. And thank you very much. I appreciate it. I wish I could give you guys a hug out there, but I want to give a hug back to you guys. And free hugs. Yeah, I want to give out the free hugs, just like everybody says. Free hugs all around. And most importantly, Jesus is where it's at. God believes in you. Just believe in your own self in the world. Don't be a follower to everybody else. Be a follower yourself. God will lead you. It's like, don't leave your stuff there. God, follow God. Follow God. Don't follow the other people. Follow God. Believe in that word. Believe that God, if you follow God, God will do the rest. Don't go with the other followers. Go with God. Okay, tell yourself, I want to follow God and not the other people. You'll get somewhere in this life. Anyway, good night, everybody. Good night.